Happy morning, dear students. Welcome to Science Online class. In our previous class, we revised chapter 1 in biological science, and today we are going to revise the first chapter in chemistry, matter. And most of the students are doing your classwork regularly and neatly. Except few children, you can buy your notebooks fast and try to copy down the notes in the classwork. Children, in today's session, we are going to revise about matter, the three states of matter and properties of each state of matter, and also about the interconversion of states of matter and the composition of matter. So, what is matter? Matter is anything that occupies space and has mass. So, you see various things around you. So you can see lot of things present around you, and some of these things are big and some are small. Some things are very heavy, but some are lightweighted. You can touch and feel all of these things because they are all made up of matter, and even air is made up of matter. So when you inflate a balloon, when you blow air inside the balloon, some air is trapped inside the balloon. So air is also an matter because air occupies space as well as it has mass. Okay, so that's why we say matter is anything, any object or anything that occupies a space. For example, when I place a ball on the ground, it occupies some space in the ground. So that's why we call it as matter, and it has mass. Okay, it has got some weight or mass. So we can say anything that occupies some space, which takes up some space and has a mass, we call it as matter. So the food we eat, the water we drink, and the air we breathe, and the clothes we wear, everything, okay, all kind of things are made up of matter. A book, a pen, a chair, the fan, table are also made up of matter because everything occupies space and has mass. So even the eraser we use, the scale we use, everything is considered to be a matter. So the space occupied by an object is called its volume. So what is volume? The space anything occupies is called its volume. So for example, the space occupied by a football is greater than the space occupied by a tennis ball because the football is larger than the tennis ball. So that's why we say the volume. Volume is space occupied by a thing. Okay, so the volume of a football is greater than that of tennis ball, which means football occupies more space than a tennis ball. So you can realize that something has mass when you lift or weigh it. So when you lift any object, you will be able to feel the weight of the object, and the amount of matter anything contain is called its mass. So what is mass? Mass is the amount of matter anything contains. So how much matter an object or anything contain is called its mass. So as the mass increases, the weight also increases. So this activity clearly explains that air also is considered as a matter. So kids, what are the two criteria for matter? First one, it should occupy space, that is it must have a volume, and second one is it must have a mass. So we can prove that air is also matter by doing this activity. So first you have to inflate a balloon. The balloon becomes bigger in size because the air gets trapped inside the balloon. So this shows that air occupies some space. So now you prepare a weighing scale and tie two uninflated, okay, uninflated balloons at two sides of the scale, and you will find that both the balloons are equal in weight. So then you inflate. Inflate means you blow air into one of them and put it back in the place in the Wien scale. So you can see that the inflated balloon is heavier than the uninflated one. So that means the balloon with air is heavier than the balloon without air. So this is because air is trapped in the balloon and air has mass. This experiment clearly shows us that air is a matter because it has both volume and mass. Now let's move on to the states of matter. So there are three states of matter, which is solid, liquid and gaseous states. So you know that when we heat a cube of ice, so when we heat ice, what happens? The ice melts into water and the water evaporates into water vapor. So when we cool, what happens? The water vapor changes into water and water ultimately become ice. So you can see in this picture how ice on heating converts to water. On further heating, it converts to water vapor. Water vapor on cooling becomes water. On further cooling, it becomes ice. Ice, water and water vapor are all water, but they are said to be in three different states. Ice is said to be in solid state, water is in the liquid state and water vapor is in the gaseous state. So other substances also behave in the similar way. So that's how matter exists in three states. They are solid, liquid and gas. So children, in your exam point of view, certain questions are very important to you. You must know to define matter, you must know what is mass and what is volume, and you must also know the experiment to prove that air is a matter. So the balloon experiment. Next children, let's see what causes the difference in state of matter. So why there is a difference in three state of matter? So we know that any kind of matter is made up of very small particles called as molecules. There are some space between the molecules and this space is called as, yes children, it is right, intermolecular space. And the molecules are held together by a force, okay, a force of attraction, which is called as intermolecular force or cohesion. Intermolecular space is the space between the molecules and intermolecular force is the force which held the molecules together, the force of cohesion or attraction between the molecules. So the intermolecular space is very minimum in the solid state because the molecules are tightly packed in the solid state, so there is not much space between the molecules. But in the liquid state, the molecules are not tightly packed, so there is little bit more space between the molecules in the liquid state. But in a gaseous state, there is more intermolecular space between the molecules. And in other words, we can also say that the intermolecular force is more in solid, little bit less in liquid, and it is lesser in the gaseous state. So based on these differences, we are going to learn the properties of the different states of matter. The first property is shape and volume. So we know that all solids have a fixed shape and a fixed volume. So solids are generally hard because all the molecules are very tightly packed in the solids. For example, you can imagine a stone or a nail or anything, a book or a box or anything, whatever it is, all solid, they usually have a definite size and shape. But a liquid has a fixed volume but no fixed shape. A liquid has a fixed volume, even though liquid has a fixed volume, but there is no shape. So you cannot say in what shape water is. Okay, when we pour it in a cylindrical tumbler, it looks as if it is cylindrical. When we pour it in a bowl, it looks as if it is circular. So it a liquid always takes the shape of the container. and the gas has neither a fixed volume nor a fixed shape. It assumes the volume and shape of the container. So we have seen in solid has a fixed shape and a fixed volume. Liquid has a fixed volume but it does not have a fixed shape. It takes the shape of the container. Whereas a gas has neither a fixed volume nor a fixed shape. It takes the shape and volume of the container. Next, let's move on to see the compressibility of solid, liquid and gas. So children, I want you all to imagine of a solid. Can you compress a solid? No, it is not possible. Can you compress a box or can you compress a pen? No, it is not possible because solid is incompressible. But a liquid can be compressed to very little extent. Okay, not that much, but very little extent liquid can be compressed because there is little intermolecular space between the molecules. No, so liquids can be compressed little bit, but a gas is compressed to very great extents. Okay, so a gas is highly compressible. You can compress a gas to a great extent. We have seen that solids are non-compressible, liquids are compressible to a very little extent, but gases is compressible to very great extent. This is because of the larger intermolecular space in the gas and very less intermolecular space in the solid and liquid. Next, children, will move on to the fluidity of a solid, liquid and a gas. Solids do not flow. Okay, solids cannot flow, but liquid and gases can flow. So this is because the force of attraction is very strong in the solid, but it is not that much strong in liquid and gas. So that's why the solid cannot flow, whereas the liquid and gases can flow. So this property of liquid and gases, the ability of liquid and gases to flow is called as fluidity or fluids. So that's why they are called as fluids. And it is the natural tendency of gas to flow from a higher pressure area to a lower pressure zone. So gases can normally flow from an area of higher pressure to the lower pressure. So this is how wind blows from an area of higher pressure to a lower pressure. And the intermolecular force is large in a higher pressure zone than in the lower pressure zone. So that's why they flow from the higher pressure area to the lower pressure area. Children, as all these lessons are already completed for you, I'm not going very deep. I'm just giving you the gist of the lesson and revising you the important key points. So next we are going to see the thermal expansion of solid, liquid and gas. So what is meant by thermal expansion? Thermal expansion means the expansion on being heated. So when we heat a solid or a liquid or gas, how does it expand? So that is called as thermal expansion. Thermal means heat, and so it is like when we apply heat, how does it expand? So when we heat something, the molecules in it will absorb the energy. So when we heat something, the molecule will absorb the heat energy and it will start moving apart from each other. So when there is very less or little intermolecular force, molecules will move and larger is the expansion. So what we can understand is when the intermolecular force is very less, when we heat that particular thing, then the molecules will move. Okay, the molecules will move and it will expand more. So which has the lowest intermolecular force? The intermolecular force is very small in the It is very less in the gas. So when we heat gas, what happens is the gas will start to expand, and the expansion is greater in gas than in liquid and the expansion is very less or very little in the solid. Children, next let's move on to interconversion of states of matter, that is change in state of matter. So do you remember what is interconversion of state? The change in state of matter from one to another is called interconversion of state. So like water, other substances also change the state when we heat or cool it at the right degree. So this change of state from one to another is called as interconversion. There are solid to liquid interconversion, liquid to gas interconversion, solid directly to vapor interconversion. We'll shortly discuss about each of these types of interconversion. So what is solid to liquid interconversion? When we heat a solid to a particular temperature, the solid changes into liquid. So this is called as solid to liquid interconversion, and this process is called as melting. The temperature at which a solid melts is known as melting point. For example, ice melt at 0 degree and carbon will melt at 3550 degrees Celsius. So each of the metals and each of the elements have different temperature as their melting points. So next is So what is freezing? When we cool something, okay, when we keep some liquid inside the freezer and when you cool it, what happens? The liquid changes into solid at a particular temperature. So this is called as this process in which there is a change in state from liquid to solid. Okay, when liquid change to solid, it is known as freezing, and the temperature at which it changes is called as freezing point. So interestingly, the freezing point of a liquid is same as the melting point of the corresponding solid. So the melting point of a solid and the freezing point of a liquid is same. So water freezes at 0 degree Celsius and ice melt at 0 degree Celsius. So both ice and water coexist together at this temperature. So next let's move on to liquid to gas interconversion. So what is liquid to gas interconversion? Is when you heat a liquid to a particular degree of temperature, that is for example when you heat milk or when you heat water, what happens after some time you can notice bubbles rising from this. So this phenomena is known as boiling, and the corresponding temperature at which a liquid boils is called as boiling point. The next is gas to liquid interconversion. So what happens here? When a gas changes into liquid, when we cool at a particular temperature, this phenomena is called as condensation. So the change of a gas to a liquid is called as condensation or liquefaction. So a substance in the gaseous state is cooled. When we cool a substance in gaseous state, it will change to the corresponding liquid. So it will change into a liquid. So this process is called as condensation or liquefaction. And some solids will vaporize, that is it change into vapor directly. So this phenomena is called as sublimation. So you would have noticed the mothball or naphthalene ball or even the air freshness. Okay, when we keep it exposed, what happens is it becomes smaller and finally one day it disappears. So in fact, because it is made up of a chemical called as naphthalene, which has the property to sublime, which means to convert into gas at room temperature. Okay, next children, we'll quickly revise the composition of matter. So we know that matter is composed of elements. So what are elements? The substance that cannot be split into simpler substances by chemical means or by chemical reaction, they are called as element. For example, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, iron, copper, all these are elements. Because we cannot split it in, or we cannot divide it into more simpler substance through any chemical reaction. And these elements are represented by symbols. We have got symbols for all the elements. For example, hydrogen is represented by the symbol H, nitrogen by N, oxygen O. So similarly, each of the element has got a symbol. So next, let's see what is an compound. So when two or more elements, when they chemically combine with each other, a compound is formed. For example, hydrogen combined with oxygen to form water. So water is a compound. We can split water into hydrogen and oxygen, and also carbon combined with oxygen to form compound carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide can also be split into carbon and oxygen. So substance that can split into simpler substance by chemical mean is called a compound. So finally, let's see what is an atom. Okay, atom is the smallest part of an element that can take part in a chemical reaction. Okay, so atom is the basic indivisible part of an element which can take part in a chemical reaction. And atoms does not exist independently. Atoms cannot exist independently. So they combine with each other to form a molecule. So what is molecule? A molecule is the smallest part of an element or a compound that is capable of independent existence. So molecule is the smallest part of an element or a compound which can exist independently. So the molecules are, for example, an atom of hydrogen combined with another atom of hydrogen to form a molecule of hydrogen. A hydrogen molecule is represented by the formula H2. Okay, similarly, the molecule of nitrogen is represented by the formula N2. Molecule of oxygen is represented by the formula O2. Okay, now let's see about the molecules of compounds. Okay, they are also represented by formula. So two atom of hydrogen combined with one atom of oxygen to form a molecule of water. Their formula is H2O. And one atom of nitrogen combined with three atom of hydrogen to form a molecule of ammonia. So similarly, by the help of a formula, we will be able to say how many atoms of which element constitute the molecule. And the formulas for the molecule of element or a compound is standard. Okay, it does not change. So only two atom of hydrogen can combine with one atom of oxygen to form a water molecule. So it is a standard formula and it cannot change. So children, in this session we have revised that anything that occupies space and has mass, it is called as dash, it is called as matter. And the space anything occupies is called its volume. The amount of matter anything contains is called the mass, and matter is made up of very small particles called as molecules, and the space between the molecules are called as intermolecular space, and the molecules are held by a force called as intermolecular force or cohesion. And the matter exists in three states, that is solid, liquid and gas states. So the properties of these three states can be understood in terms of the intermolecular space and the intermolecular force. And the change in state of matter from one to another is called the interconversion of states. Next, an element is a substance that cannot be split into simpler substance by chemical means, whereas a compound is a substance that can be split into simpler substance by chemical means. And matter is made up of very small particles called as molecules that can exist independently. And molecules are made up of still small particles called as atoms. And atoms cannot exist independently. A molecule of element is made up of atoms of only one kind, whereas a molecule of compound is made up of atoms of two or more kinds. And the force that holds the atom together is called a chemical bond. And this chemical bond is very much stronger than the intermolecular force. So students, I hope this quick recap would have been useful for you. So you can copy down the notes I have sent and also learn the notes and you can go through the book pages I have sent in your WhatsApp. Children, I'll very soon intimate to you about the activity to be done for this month. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.